I think what's happening in the startup ecosystem today is total bullshit. I find it amusing when a loss-making company is allowed to list on the stock market and is allowed to take public's money home. It's become a nexus. Mera naam hai startup mein. Next round ho jayega tera, tension mat le. I'm like, this is not startup community. This is the circus community of India. I feel that media of this country is doing the biggest injustice by not highlighting, recognizing and celebrating the MSMEs of this country. Firstly, the entire financial system of the world is a fraud. It's a scam.
We figured out that whatever idea you have, you go with it.
Yeah.
So people, a lot of people, A, they have already, they're working on their small businesses or large businesses or startups. And B, someone, let's just say, is now ready to pick up the idea. And usne start kar liya ek research ke hisab se. He's like started transactioning 1,000, 2,000, 10,000. He's like started making good, right? Mm. How do we scale the business? How do people scale their businesses? How do they make it big? Because in the beginning, I know, I think there's one thing which I've also learned from you is team building wala part, where I've realized that hustle is really important when you start the business. But then hustle becomes the bigger problem and the biggest problem for you if you still hustle while you're scaling the business.
Oh.
And if you're doing everything by yourself, you get in the zone which you call it firefighting.
Yeah, yeah.
Rather than actually getting results for the business. Yeah. So most of the entrepreneurs, they start the business, they do everything by themselves. Mm-hmm. Like myself, I did everything by myself. And now I am so fucked up in my head that ये मैं बढ़ाऊं कैसे, because मैं सब नहीं कर सकता. Because of those everything which I was doing, two things have started taking shape. Mm-hmm. And now I want to focus on two things. But if I leave the other 10 things which I'm doing, I won't be able to focus on the next two things. So how do I get out of this zone where I am delegating in a team and giving it to the people so that I focus only on the two things which are making sense to me the most?
So I'll tell you exactly why hustle is important till when hustle is important. Firstly, hustle is good to get your hands dirty to create a proof of concept. Concept of the product or concept of the capability. Tab tak tum haath pair maro, tum har kisi ke liye koi bhi kaam karo. To figure out what is the right product or service, who is the right customer. Till then you burn your hands.
Hmm.
Okay. Do it all so you understand all angles of your space, your industry. So hustle is great till you establish a proven business model. What is a proven business model? Simply put, it is who's my customer? Which means who has the money and the need. What's the product or service they're willing to spend their money on? Which is the capability I need to develop to deliver that product or service? And what's the right price point? Which means it should be profitable for me and it should be competitive for the customer. Yeah. Right? So hustle is good till you reach that stage of creating a workable business model.
Okay.
Once you create a workable business model, then the trap most people fall into is they do everything. They are the ones who are selling. They are the ones who are taking care of the customer. They are doing end-to-end of the business and that makes you feel like a superhero. Okay? But that's the stupidest thing anybody can do. 99% of people go the stupid path. Okay? What you need to understand is this. Once you have a proven business model, next you have to make it profitable.
Hmm.
Now, to make it profitable, there has to be consistency of money coming in. For money to come in consistently, there has to be consistency of clients coming in.
Hmm.
Now, where do most businesses fail? Where do the most hustlers fail? Is that if you are selling and then you are servicing by yourself, when you are servicing, you can't sell. When you're selling, you're not servicing. So there, it's like, you know, you've seen that hand pump.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Aise samajh lo ki tum hand pump maar rahe ho, fir tum ja ke paani pee rahe ho. Theek hai? Ab wo rukega hand pump, fir tum peeche bhagoge, fir hand pump maroge. So that's where you need to make sure that from workable business model, you got to go to profitable business model. And for business to be profitable, income has to be consistent. For income to be consistent, selling should be consistent and servicing both should be consistent, which means you can't do both.
Hmm.
Okay. So you have to have someone who's marketing, generating leads. You have to have someone who's selling. You have to have someone who's delivering what has been sold. Now, in the initial stages, it is okay for you to build a team in one area and be the person who's doing one activity by yourself. It's perfectly fine. That's when you see consistency of the activity is making you money. You make profit. Once you reach profitability, the next step is to make sure that you squeeze the juice out of the opportunity that is there. And for that, you need to widen your spectrum. You need to add new products or services or explore new markets explore partnerships and stuff like that. So for you to move from that stage where you're profitable, where you're making money, because that also can be a trap. Huh?
Yeah.
Because I've seen people, 3 lakh kama raha hu, 5 lakh kama raha hu. Agar subah 9 baje ko dukaan khud kholna hai aur raat ko 11 baje ko shutter khud niche karna hai, that's life. But you lose creative juices over a period of time. Money doesn't bring that joy over a period of time. Money makes sense to a guy when he's not having money. That's the chase, na? Ki, yeah. Oh, I want to make the money.
Yeah.
But once you start averaging your 3 lakhs, 5 lakhs, 8 lakh rupees a month, then over a period of time, money loses meaning. And when money loses meaning and you are the one who has to still do the same stuff, then it fucks with your mind, right? So then you got to look at, okay, I totally believe an entrepreneur should not expect consistency and focus from himself or herself. An entrepreneur is a creator. You got to keep disrupting and creating. Okay? You are, if there is Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh, if you're trying to be Vishnu, you're screwed, my friend. You can't be the operator. You have to be Mahesh. You have to be the destroyer, right? You have to keep disrupting the next level. For that, you don't mess with what's working. So what do you do? You build a team. You set up a system to take care of what is working.
Yeah.
Okay? Now, you need to build that second line of leaders, second line of managers, which is, again, a totally different process. Because in hustle, you are the product expert. You are the service expert. You love that product or service. You love doing it by yourself. Okay? But now, you got to learn how to fall in love with something that you may not see as your strength, which is developing people, which is where you need to bring in patience, which is where you need to bring in detailing, which is where you need to bring in empathy, which is where you need to bring in a lot of nurturing. Okay? And if you're able to crack that, then you reach a stage where you have a team and a system that's taking care of the day-to-day. Okay? And when the day-to-day is sorted, then you focus on growth. Then you go flirt with new ideas. Then you go flirt with new opportunities. Okay? You figure out what's the next big game. Okay? And then, as you've kind of integrated a business model where you have significant presence in the space that you're doing what you're doing in, then you look at scale. Then you look at, say, something where you have a decentralized management in place. You've blown up the brand. You've built something that will live beyond you. That's when you've achieved true nirvana in business. So it's like this. I would look at it as building a business is like driving a geared vehicle. Tum jab car start karte ho, you can't start the car on fourth gear. First gear pe jana padega, hustle karna padega. But you can't keep driving in first gear. Right? Then you'll have to transition to second gear, where you have to make sure ki marketing consistently ho raha hai, sales consistently ho raha hai, operations consistently ho raha hai. So you start building basic teams. Then you got to move to third and fourth gear, which is where you have second line of leaders and managers. You are exploring new opportunities. Okay. And then you will never put a car on cruise control on first gear or second gear. When you reach fourth gear, when you have the highway prepared for you, you're going at 120, 130 kilometers per hour, then you press cruise control.
Yeah.
That's how it is. That's how building a business is. Where most people get stuck is that they go into this I factor. But Rajiv, this is not my personality. Okay, I'm a hustler. To raho bhai, tum raho, tum jindagi bhar freelancer jaise kaam karo aur khush raho. Okay, you got to remove your identity out of a business. You got to be like water, like Bruce Lee said. You got to take the form of the vessel. The vessel requires me to shift now. I will shift now.
Yeah.
Because once I've set my legacy up, nobody will ask Mark Zuckerberg today ki tum baith ke khud coding kyun kar rahe ho. He can afford to. Yeah. But he's built it till this place.
True.
Right? So build it.
Now, you explained the entire model, which is crazy. But you like fast forwarded everything.
Okay.
Okay.
So let's go deep.
Let's make it slow.
Yeah.
And I'll again get back to like 2016 wala session. where one of the things, key things which I picked up from you was you need to, like, a business has 7 different departments.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So I got the central idea of entire thing which we're trying to explain for 3 days, that you need to build a second line of leaders. And right now what you said made complete sense.
Mm.
That yes, you need to do that because you as a creator, as an entrepreneur, you loved doing this because you were the disruptor. You were the creative person. You were the one who was actually disrupting everything. You were never this person who were like consistently trying to do everything, right? You loved it. Ab, you want to go to the second part where you want, so that everything is happening consistently, you want to build a second line of leaders. That second line of leaders will be only built when you develop it.
Mm.
But to develop that, there are 7 departments in a business.
Mm.
So I learned that. I was like, brilliant. Main mere business mein jata hun, 7 departments ke 7 head khade kar deta hun, and then my life would be sorted. And those 7 departments, first was marketing, then sales, then operations, then HR, accounts and finance, then R&D, and the last one was management.
Yep.
So the 6 people would now talk to management. The management would guide them in order to go ahead. Right? This was it. I was like, this made sense. Kya maza, kitni easy baat thi, sirf itna business hota hai. But once I hired them, and I hired the best people around, okay, because I thought everything which I'm making, let me reinvest in the business.
Mm.
And I was running an FMCG business. So I hired guys from Unilever.
Mm.
I hired guys from DS Group. Hired guys like all the big companies. It was a blunder. I made the biggest mistake of my life by hiring like all top guys from top 7 departments.
Basically, you got Fufaji's at an Indian wedding. That's what you did. Go ahead.
Okay. Now, and this is the mistake which most of the people make, that the moment you talk about this, like, let's build a second line of leader, let's build a team.
Mm.
They start looking at the tags. Mm. Ki, okay, main mera CTO na, is company ka CTO leke aata hun, toh ye ban jayega. मेरे लिए मार्केटिंग वाला इसमें मार्केटिंग को अच्छी करा तो लेके आ जाता हूँ. बिजनेस मैनेजर एक्स एजेंसी में उसने बहुत कमा के दिया तो मेरे पास लेके आ जाता हूँ. राइट? एंड देन दैट्स हाउ यू बिल्ड द एंटायटी.
वो उसका नहीं रहा, तुम्हारा क्या रहेगा? सिंपल सी बात है.
देन व्हाट शुड वी डू?
यू आइदर पे बाय मनी और यू पे बाय टाइम. सो इफ यू डोंट हैव द मनी टू पे, देन यू पे बाय टाइम. यू हायर पीपल हु मे नॉट हैव द स्किल्स एंड नॉलेज, but have the threshold characteristics, the hunger to learn, the passion to learn, okay? And ye kisi ke chehre pe likha nahi hota. You get 10, you're left with 2. But those 2 then becomes your love story.
Yeah.
Okay? Where you're eating together, sleeping together, breathing together, okay? Dreaming together, okay? Yeah. Managing chaos together.
I love this line.
Right? So, out of those 10, you look for 2. You don't get disappointed with the 8. Ki wo aa gaya, mujhse seekh ke gaya. Hota hai yaar. That's the journey. If you can't handle that in business, you're not meant for business. Simple as that.
But I love this. Like, just want to highlight it again that if you can't pay with money, you pay with time.
Yeah.
Because then you have to invest your time in order to coach them, train them, make them fall in love with what you do.
Yeah.
Make show them that this is the baby you care about a lot. So even you need to care in the same way. That's what you got to do.
You got to, like, you got to live in each other's shadow. And you got to be intrusive in each other's life.
Mm.
I need to have a problem if those two, if they're not eating properly. I need to have a problem with that.
Yeah.
I need to fight with them for that. Okay. If one went through a breakup, I need to take him out for a drink and tell him, ho jata hai, theek hai, next. Right? That's how intrusive your life has to be with each other. That's how your core team is formed. Core teams are not formed in 9-to-5 environments. The work may end at 5. After that, you still hang out with them. That's how core teams are built.
I think that's my problem. That's one of the biggest problems I am going through, where I treat the person who is an expert, let's say we're getting him at a 2 lakh threshold, versus the person who I'm getting at an intern level, I treat them both in the same way. And that's a bad thing to do.
Yeah.
Because one, I pay in money, and the other, I need to pay in time.
Yeah. And you need to make both earn something. Nah? The guy you're paying in time, his earning is him showing progress in skill. The guy you're paying in money, his earning is him showing progress in connection.
Okay. Now I had a question that a lot of startups these days, they go for the pitch decks and pitch banake, they go for fundings, right? the moment they get funding, they just have, like, let's say, a proof of concept. They don't have profits. They don't have a possibility of, like, a good PMF in place as well, because they're testing it out. So what they do is, before figuring out what's the profitability, before figuring out their business model, before figuring out their entire revenue model, how things are going to work, they start hiring. Do you think it's a good way or a bad way? Because the moment they get funding, they feel, now I need to get the best talent on board and then everything will be figured out. So do you think that's a good way to approach things? Because most of the startups do this.
Want me to be nice or honest?
Honest. Come on.
So I'll give you my unfiltered, honest version. Okay. I think what's happening in the startup ecosystem today is total bullshit.
Why? Okay?
The fundamental of business will never change. Business is always going to be a value creation exercise. What they've made it today is a circus of valuations. Iski topi, uske sir. Let's face it. Today, a guy who's investing in you knows who he's going to bring on board as a next round investor.
Yeah.
Right? I won't name it, but I've had some of the biggest VC houses in India, heads who've told me, Rajiv, abroad se itna paisa aa raha hai. Agar the guy is able to get a meeting with me, if he's able to reach that stage of getting a meeting with me, I'll pump money. Mere ko 100 mein se ek chahiye. अब तुम तो ला रहे हो बाहर का पैसा, तुम यहाँ डाल रहे हो, तुम बोलोगे हम नेशन की इकोनॉमी बूम कर रहे हैं, स्टार्टअप्स को, एंटरप्रेन्योर्स को सपोर्ट कर रहे हैं, मीडिया भी डफली बजा के बोल रहे हैं इसको इतना मिला, उसको उतना मिला, इन्वेस्टमेंट्स आर बीइंग सेलिब्रेटेड. कभी आओ हमारी गली में, आई विल शो यू एंटरप्रेन्योर्स हु मेक 50 lakhs प्रॉफिट अ वीक. आई थिंक दे डिजर्व टू बी सेलिब्रेटेड, बिकॉज दे, for a guy to make 50 lakhs profit a week, he needs to have delivered that much value that the market is willing to pay him, na?
Yeah.
Tum idhar 500 crore jalane wale ko hero bana rahe ho. Okay? Matlab, it's become a circus.
Yes.
Okay? It's the cool thing to do right now.
True.
Okay?
That's so true. 500 crore jalane wale ko hero bana rahe ho, lekin 50 lakh kamane wale ko nahi.
Are, chalo, kahin bhi local market mein chalo. Banda Activa pe aayega, par har hafte 50 lakh ghar leke jayega. तुम ट्विटर पे बैठे हुए को हीरो बना रहे हो, राइट? सो वी आर लिविंग इन अ सर्कस एनवायरनमेंट, एंड या देयर कैन बी आर्ग्यूमेंट्स, बट इजंट, आरंट वी बूमिंग एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप एज अ कल्चर इन इंडिया? ओके, आरंट वी क्रिएटिंग वेल्थ फॉर द द टीम मेंबर्स हु आर स्टिकिंग एंड बिल्डिंग अ वेंचर? यस यू आर. ओके, बट इज योर हिट रेशियो बेटर देन अ ट्रेडिशनल बिजनेस? इट्स डेफिनेटली नॉट. Traditional businesses have a better hit ratio. MSMEs provide 75% of the employment of the country. They create, they pay more taxes. These guys learn how to evade taxes. Singapore mein company register karo, Dubai ka tum golden card le lo, ho gaya tax evasion. Okay, kahan startup India? Which India is growing over here? The real India is on the streets, my friend. The real India is in small businesses, in homes turned into offices. It's not in plush co-working spaces. That's not real India. So let's put the truth out for the generation of tomorrow to get their priorities right. I come from Bangalore. In every coffee shop, there are 3 tables pitching at any given point of time. And I can tell you, there's no head or tail. The guy is chasing, how will I raise my next round of funding?
Yeah.
And there's a few elite who've cracked this model, and they've, it's become a nexus. Mera naam hai startup mein. Next round ho jayega tera, tension mat le. That's how the game works. Okay, so someone's looking pitch deck, proof of concept. People come and ask me, Rajiv, can you help me create my pitch deck? Bhai, pitch deck kyun chahiye? Just pick one of these guys, give them a 3%. He'll take care of everything else for you. Okay?
Yeah, I know this. I know there are guys who take 2% of your funding money and they make sure that you make, that you get a funding round.
The truth is not spoken. Okay? It's been shown like this very, this very empowering activity of nation building, that we are building startups and therefore let's hire. And what's happening with those hires? Okay. How many of them even last? How many of them, the ones who last, how many of them actually get value? Because then in fine print, kuch likha hota hai. Ki फाइन प्रिंट में इसका मतलब ये, तुम्हारा ये बनता है। सो भाई सिंधी हूँ, प्रॉफिट समझता हूँ। फॉर मी वैल्यू क्रिएशन इज मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट देन वैल्यूएशन, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। द फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ बिजनेस कैन नॉट बी चेंज्ड। डोंट यू फाइंड इट अम्यूजिंग दैट देर आर कंपनीज दैट हैव गॉन टू एन IPO एट एन ओवर प्राइज्ड eroded wealth of the common man and have been allowed to do that by the system, okay? Allowed to do that by the system, okay? And then they are saying that our business model is work in progress. Tum nasha kar rahe ho kya? Ki tum IPO ke baad bol rahe ho our business model is work in progress. When I hear such things from the so-called entrepreneurs who represent the startup community of India, I'm like, this is not startup community. This is the circus community of India. That's what's happening there.
So we need to shift the focus from role models, or what should we do here?
Education. Okay. Please let's talk about also the other side of the spectrum of guys who've left established jobs, taken the plunge into startups, okay, and have ruined their careers. Please let's talk about those entrepreneurs who burnt money and didn't just burn money, but also lost belief in themselves over a period of time. Let it not be the nexus of 80-100 people that is running and creating the business culture of this country. Okay. Let us talk both. Na? And let us see my biggest bone. Okay. Unpopular. My PR team will kill me for this, but I'm saying it. I feel that media of this country is doing the biggest injustice by not highlighting, recognizing and celebrating the MSMEs of this country. You are celebrating either MNCs, which are large corporates, or you are celebrating startups, which are technically not even Indian. Most of them are Singapore registered.
Yeah, Delaware or Singapore, yeah.
Right. And what are you celebrating? You are celebrating headlines like, so-and-so raised this much at this round of valuation. So-and-so raised this much at this round of valuation. Can you celebrate? I'll tell you. Mere baju mein grocery wala uncle hai. Usne 6 dukaan khol diye lockdown ke baad. Usko celebrate karo tum. Wo asli mein tax bharta hai yahan. Okay? Wo jobs create kar raha hai. Wo entrepreneurs create kar raha hai. Apne team member ko partner bana raha hai. I have a simple rule. Whatever you see out there, go in the opposite direction.
What do you mean by this?
You're seeing startup everywhere. Go in the opposite direction. Build an MSME. Go do the unglamorous stuff of building a manufacturing unit. Okay. Go do the unglamorous thing of building a brick and mortar business and take it to scale. I'm a fan of Zerodha.
It's crazy.
Okay. Yeah. There is ethos there. Okay. There's a value system guiding that business there. Okay. That should be the heroic story we should be telling. Okay. I find it amusing when a loss-making company is allowed to list on the stock market and is allowed to take public's money home.
So what the problem is with the valuations or raising the funds, or is it the problem that you should not be celebrated until and unless you have proven your way to profitability and empowerment and value creation?
Illogical, unproven business models is the fundamental problem. Okay.
And why is this happening? Because VCs want to just want one winner and that's why just pumping money? Why is this happening? Because, see,
you know, the money.
What you said makes complete sense. Okay.
The money.
But what I'm thinking, let me complete it is, someone who's putting in the money might not be a complete fool.
He
is putting money. He's very smart. Why are they putting in the money?
They're not. Okay, now I'm going to tread into a direction which is even more riskier. No. So I'm putting myself on the line, Raj Shamani, for the show. Just letting you know. Okay, I'll tell you what happens. Okay, if you do some study of world economics, and there are some documentaries that I can recommend. Firstly, the entire financial system of the world is a fraud. It's a scam. If you understand how money gets created, printed, Okay, you go on, there's a website on US Debt Tracker where you can see the live debt of United States of America, mm-hmm. which, and that debt can never be repaid. Money is only getting printed. It can never be repaid. So let's understand the foundation is the flaw. The entire financial system of the world is a flaw. Now, in that flawed financial system of the world, money is getting printed. Across the world, okay, if an investor makes 2%, 3%, 4%, 5%, they are super happy. Okay. We are a growing country.
Mm-hmm.
You come to my dad, who's a Sindhi businessman, and you tell him, ki uncle, aapka paisa main 4% 5% return dunga, wo bolega main baju wale ko byaj pe chadunga 18% kamaunga. Okay?
Yeah.
That's the traditional business psychology. The global wealth holders, for them 3%, 5%, 8% is great. It's mind-blowing return. Okay? And the global wealth creators are not the ones you see on Twitter.
Mm.
They are the ones who are controlling the world, running the world. And the ones we know are the ones whose PR has done a good job.
Yes.
Right? Now, if somebody overseas wants a 5 to 8% or 10%, 5 to 8% return, is mind-blowing. Now, who manages their wealth? Their wealth is managed by financial institutions. You take any financial fraud in the world. Where do you think it got created? It got created in the boardrooms of these financial institutions. Okay. Now, these financial institutions, what are they good at? They're good at giving you an Excel sheet with next 5 years projections.
Mm.
Okay. They're good at giving you a valuation report, which looks sexy.
Yeah.
If you actually value the business to its truth, none of these guys will have any work to do in the world. Right?
True.
Okay. They are forecasting a future. They are telling you a story that you want to hear. Okay. And is there some truth in that story? Yes, there is truth in that story. Yes, there is need in logistics. Yes, there is need in food delivery. Yes, there is need in fintech. There's no two ways about it. Okay. But the way the stories are amplified then. Okay. And then you play an all or nothing game. Right? You're like, 100 ko diya. One gives me an alpha return. It works for my principal, the man or the woman who's investing with me.
Yep.
It shows as a badge of honor that I was one of the early investors in this space. Okay. And we backed this. So, uska to achievement ho gaya na bhai. Jisko jo milna tha, usko bhi mil gaya. Ab, jinke role pair hai, unka kya? So, look, am I not for raising funds? I am. But I'm for raising funds when there's clarity of a business model. A fund has to be used to scale, not to construct the dream. Or not to construct the story that you sold in a reality. You need to have a base proof, no?
That is missing.
Yeah, that's missing in most cases.
Because, and it is happening because, okay, there can be two ways. Is it because people are aspiring wrong role models? Or maybe the media is celebrating something else? Or is it because few people have figured out that, hey, you know what? It's very easy to trick the system. Let me be selfish and make the most out of it.
I don't know. I've not got into the minds of those who are doing it to say that they are selfish. Probably they don't even see it with a negative intent. They see it as genuine wealth creation. They could be watching this and abusing me right now, saying, kya baat kar raha hai? Pagal hai kya? Dunya pagal hai kya? Hai bhai, dunya pagal hai. Sach sabko sunna achha nahi lagta. Right? But I truly feel that the education is missing. Okay. Mm. Firstly, that's where society fails.
Okay.
When there's not enough required education. So one, education is missing. Second, with education missing, and then celebration happening again and again, okay, of the same thing, then obviously it becomes mass consciousness and conditioning, na?
Yep.
Ki startup is sexy, fundraising is sexy. That's what I want to be. I want to be sexy.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So lack of education and then celebration of something that does not have foundational value. I think these are the two driving root causes for the business culture deteriorating in our environment today.
It makes a lot of sense because every day I'm reading about XYZ startup raising fund and they are being celebrated way more than, you know, what I see other people doing, like the foundation business. I'll tell you, there have been points in my life where I have met ex-founder. They have raised, let's say, at $100 million round. Mm. And my business, without raising any fund, is making way more money than they can. They are even projecting to get profits after 3 years.
Yeah.
Okay. But they have been celebrating more. So I feel, mere business ka bhi to fundraise hona chahiye. Mera bhi to valuation hona chahiye. Why not? Because that's more sexy. And that's what is appealing.
I'll tell you.
Because every day we are reading this.
And that's my discomfort. That's what makes me cringe. That today you have founders who just to go out there and toot their horn saying, we raised a round of investing, are willing to give away equity. Equity is expensive. Okay. If you're genuinely building something of meaning, you will hold it to your chest. Why would you give it away? Equity is expensive. And people don't value that.
Mm.
People don't value that. With what they're seeing being celebrated in the media today, you have traditional businesses who are like, sir, aap equity le lo humse. Kyun? Tum dena kyun chahte ho? First, wo socho tum. Because it's like posting a picture on Instagram. People don't take pictures because they want memories. They take pictures because they want likes. Okay? In the same way today, people are building businesses not because they want to create value, but because they want to show valuation.
Makes sense.
Right.
Yeah, it is right. It's a hard truth.
It's the dirty truth. Okay. I'd never be called to any of these startup conferences ever to speak.
We will build one. We'll call you at the startup
never,
conference.
Never.
Wow. Okay. So let me get all of this into the ending notes so that people who are watching this, they start their journey with the right foot. How can they get educated, A?
Mm.
And B, then what should be their next steps in order to build the right business or scale the right business? Because there are people watching.
Yeah.
Their business are doing considerably well.
Yeah.
They're creating good startups. But they are in this game like, should I raise more? Should I chase valuation? Should I chase do this and that?
Mera ek joke hai. Jyadatar unicorn nahi, unicorn hote hai. So, C-O-R-N nikal do, C-O-N bana do. Okay?
I think we are going to get cancelled.
Okay? Corn hai, matlab, wo ek zamana tha na, Ponzi scheme.
Yeah.
Ye aaj ka Ponzi hai. Theek hai? Okay? Now, coming back to what should people do?
Education. Starting from education and then what should...
I'm a big sucker for clarity.
Hmm.
Okay? And I feel all this chase of money, building businesses is all great. Till either you come to a realization ki sukoon ki neend is way more precious than calling yourself a unicorn. Or you come to terms ki yaar, bhaad mein jaye sukoon ki neend. Okay? Humko to bas status chahiye. So if you're chasing status, go play this game. Today you are in the right place, okay? With the right environment for you. Because you're chasing status, okay? Because you want to be like this mafia of this world where you're like, we are this and we are that. Andar kya hai? Kisi ko pata nahi. Andar employees khush hai, kisi ko pata nahi.
Where you're paisa chasing ban raha not and, profitability but perception.
Kaun 20 saal ke baad, 10 saal ke baad hum profit? Kaun sochta hai itna yaar? Okay. He will look at becoming profitable in 10 years, 15 years. Baba, what's the guarantee? You will be alive. Okay. So, if you're chasing status, this environment is the right one. Because you will be willing to make decisions to kill your soul and do what's perceivably better than what's actually better. If you're willing to do that, please go ahead. Okay. And there are people. I'm nobody to morally judge anybody.
Yeah.
Right? But agar if you value sukoon ki neend, okay, then value creation. Product bana, service bana, identify karo customer kaun hai, bechna seekho, becho, paise banao, aur paise aise banao ki customer ko khushi lage tumko paise dene mein, tumhe lage ki maine paise kamaye hain, okay. Ye hawa mein paise banane ka jo chakkar hai na, wo bahut dangerous hai, because someday it has to get valued na, someday it has to get valued. When it has to go to the markets are ruthless. The markets are not going to hear who was your investor, who was your VC, who did your angel. Markets tumko apni sach ki aukaat dikhayenge hi dikhayenge. But udhar tak tumne agar leke gaye ho, and then you eroded people's money. Okay, common man's money. Who admired you, who read about you. And then after that, you are also not comfortable. For me, I know for a fact that there are entrepreneurs out there who've played this valuation game only to feel helpless and powerless when their board step in, when the investor has a veto power. Okay. So for me, clarity is very important. I believe every entrepreneur needs one business in their life, which I call their vocation business. Vocation ka matlab kya hai? You wake up every morning and you do that work. Khud kaam karna. That's a vocation business. People come to me and say, Rajiv, Quantum Leap, you've built a coaching company in India. You're super profitable. You built a team. You don't coach anybody anymore. Your company's valuation is at 600, 700 crores. Would you like to sell it out? I would never sell it out, even if you put another 3 zeros. And I'm not saying this without ki koi offer nahi hai, to bolne mein easy hai, right? I have thought this through, okay? I have seen some legends in the training and coaching industry who sold their business, and I hear behind the scenes stories on how they feel hollow and empty when they wake up every morning, because their purpose chale gaya hai, identity chale gaya hai. You should have a vocation business, something that you will work on by yourself and you would love doing, okay? Then you have your valuation businesses. Should you unlock wealth? Okay. Yes, you should unlock wealth. If you're good, if you're intelligent, if you're talented, if you're smart, if you're capable, please unlock wealth. Now, for you to unlock wealth, then it comes with its own challenges, right? You got to be willing to let go of that business. You got to be willing to give it away to somebody else, to a larger organization or to a board where it's not yours. Okay. If you are able to do this, I don't think in today's world, you don't just need one successful business. You need two. You need a vocation business. You need a valuation business. What's common between the both is value creation. If you can do that, you will sleep with a smile every night.
I want to ask like the ending notes. Give me like actionable points of what do you read? Like maybe like 2-3 books which you really want to, which you feel like they're really good.
That's now you're exposing me.
You don't read at all.
I don't read at all. The only book that I have read more than 2 times is the Bhagavad Gita. Okay. And I believe that...
I thought you were going to say that the only book which I've read more than 2 times is Lead or Bleed.
No, I read Lead or Bleed once. That was before giving it to the publisher for the post-edit. And it even after me reading it, it had 128 spelling mistakes. So, who cares? Okay, right. But the only book I've read twice is Bhagavad Gita, because it teaches, for me, every line in the Gita reflects on day-to-day dilemmas that we as people face. So, for me, reading and then reflecting. Okay, my biggest learning comes from reflections. And so if I'm reading something, I'll read it very slow and I'll reflect upon it. My other learning comes from my coach. I have a coach. He's like a godfather to me. His name is Ashlesh Rao. And he helps me reflect a lot. I spend like twice a month, 2-3 hours just in conversation with him. And he just asks questions. And those questions get reflection. And then the third is observation and what's happening around me politically. Economically, and I connect the dots between what's happening in politics, what's happening in economics, okay, what's happening in media, okay, because what we see is not what happens in the world,
yeah,
right? So when there's a lot of reflection time I spend over there, and if something that I like, which is guided by a value system, I adopt it. Something that I know works, but is not guided by a value system, I run away from it. And that's why I have strong, unexpressed opinions.
Yeah. I tell you, I also have this belief that reading is cheap, reflection is expensive.
Yep.
Right. And for that, what I do, there's a simple model for it. Bolne ko bahut bol sakte hain. So every time I read something, let's say even a news, for example, is saal 4% barish jada hui rural areas mein. Right. So I ask myself, looking at the headline, toh main kya karu? Just asking that helps me a lot in order to understand, okay, toh main kya karu? Matlab, kya hoga isse? Mere ko kya fayda bad raha hai?
Yeah, yeah.
And like, ki barish hoti hai, toh rural consumption badhta hai. Rural consumption badhta hai. मतलब रूरल कम जो उधर कंपनीज है जो रूरल एरियाज की वजह से ग्रोथ ही वो ज्यादा ग्रोथ होती तो उनका क्वार्टर रिजल्ट बढ़ेगा तो हो सकता है अगर मैं ट्रेडर हूँ तो मेरे लिए क्वार्टर वन और क्वार्टर टू में डिफरेंस पड़ेगा राइट सो जस्ट आस्किंग तो मैं क्या करूँ ऑन एवरी पॉइंट हेल्प्स मी अ लॉट टू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ फाइनेंशियल सिस्टम वर्क्स हाउ पीपल मेक मनी व्हाट गोज ऑन व्हाट काइंड ऑफ बिजनेसेस थ्राइव व्हेन देयर आर सर्टेन थिंग्स सो आई थिंक दैट इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट Yeah. And that's reflection pretty yep, much at yep. it.
Absolutely. I love that question. I think I'll use that as a template. Right, like, main kya karun?
Nice. Yeah, it just works. I mean, when Elon Musk, everybody said that he's coming to India for Tesla. Tesla is coming to India. And I was like, toh main kya karun? Mm. And I found out, it's a very interesting insight that there are three companies they were in talks with. Now, toh it's like, I don't know, it's pura completely different scenario. There were three companies who were going to give them batteries.
Mm.
And woh teenon company jo raw material khareedti hai, they buy it from Tata Chemicals.
Mm.
So in India, if anybody had to build the EV ecosystem,
yeah.
they'd have to buy that raw material from Tata Chemicals, which I never knew.
Yeah.
And I would have never got to know if I hadn't asked the question, like, toh main kya karu? It's such a great insight ki agar EV badega, toh you know which companies are at the forefront.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So it makes a lot of sense. What are the three mistakes which you made in your 20s, which we should take care of?
One, I was very gullible.
Okay.
Which meant...
Can you explain gullible?
I'll tell you what I meant. I chased opportunities, but not with the right people. And that kind of put me in difficult spots. And then I learned that first the person and then the opportunity. Who I'm working with is more important than what I'm working on.
First who, then what?
Yeah. So I think that's a very important lesson because I'll tell you something. If you're in your 20s and you're talented, you'll never have a dearth of opportunities. You'll never. Okay. If the fact that someone's even watching this conversation that we're having, I'd rate them as the 1% talented, conscious people. Simple as that. Okay. It's not like you have a dearth of opportunities. So one, first who, then what.
Okay.
Second mistake in my 20s is there was a stage where I made failure personal, which means my businesses didn't give me the desired result. And I made that about myself, which I think between 2012 to 2014. So that was essentially from the age of 26 to 28. I went through a very rough patch personally because I made the financial failure, a personal failure. And I went into this entire process of, I'm never going to make it. Okay. I'm not meant for big things in life and all of that. And if there's one thing that I pride myself on is 99 people who go through something like that, their life, it's a downward spiral.
Mm.
Call it blessings, call it prayers, call it the right environment and people around me. I was able to pull myself out of that downward spiral where I had become my own biggest enemy. So stop being your biggest enemy.
Yeah.
That was second one. Third lesson in your 20s is, it's a cliche, but it's the reality. You're too young to take your life so seriously. There was a growing up, there was a psychology that by 30, you need to be a millionaire.
Yeah.
By 20, you need to be established. I have kind of redefined the meaning of age for myself after that phase. For me today, it's like, till 40, you are young. At 40, you become an adult. Till 80, you are an adult. At 80, you become old. This is the way I have rewired myself. And the entire thought process is that till I'm young, I'm only going to have fun. Mm-hmm. And from 40 to 80, I am going to then look at my peak years.
I'm sure 10 years later, when we're having the conversation at 45, you're going to say, I'm still young. Yeah, 50, yeah. I'm going to start getting old. So that's not happening.
It's like this. I loved this idea once. I heard, you know, my wife and I, we travel quite a bit. And every time we travel, one of the things we observe is how we see so-called perceived senior citizens from across the world taking walks, treks, hikes, trails overseas. And here we have 35-year-olds who are acting like bas ab to jindagi khatam hone ko hai. And we travel for that. That inspiration that, you know what, you got to stay active like these people. At 75, 80, they're taking a trek, they're doing a hike. And for me, I feel that in our country, what's happened is the social conditioning has so much fear, so much negativity that people die faster. And they die every day. They don't just die once. Like, ek bar maro na, jab exit karna hai. So in that entire process, I feel the idea that I heard once from a senior gentleman, which is why I initiated this conversation, was he said, the older I get, the fitter I get. Wow, what a perspective. No? What a perspective. And it was so real for him. The older I get, the fitter I get.
I have a belief that only you take yourself seriously, no one else does.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, one passion slash hobby I would recommend to people, and this is something that I'm newly romanticizing, is astronomy. Stargazing, planet gazing, just seeing what's out there. And I was just talking to my wife a couple of nights ago. We were talking about stargazing and stuff and what models of telescopes to look at and stuff like that. And I said, the reason I love stargazing and astronomy per se is because every time you peep through that lens of the telescope and you see something out there, which is millions of light years away, you realize that you're a 5 feet, 5 inch insignificant piece of dust, and there's so much undue importance you give to yourself.
I think one of the biggest mistakes we as society make is that we attach failure with a person, not with a situation or a circumstance. Yeah. And that's the worst thing we are making. That's the worst mistake we are making. Like, if let's say I fail in my 20s, let's say I'm 25 and I fail with all of this. Yeah. People say, abhi, yeh nikamma, isse kuch nahi hota, dekh pata nahi kya karne gaya tha. It's not that maybe the timing was wrong. Maybe the thing which I did was wrong. Maybe the team was wrong. Maybe I was bad as a leader. It's not a personal failure.
Yeah.
It's just what I know as of today and how the political and the business environment is as of today was wrong, which made it a failure, not me personally.
I read a meme on Instagram. 200 rupees ki t-shirt dalne wale Met Gala ke outfits ko judge karte hain. That's the world we live in, right? And look, I say this with absolute love, humility, and compassion for all of us as people, that we are all doing our best. We all are. Even the guy who's not going to work is still doing his or her best, right? And I think when the world starts developing that compassion, that everybody is doing their best and nobody has their answers, nobody's figured anything out, okay? You've had some legends sit on this couch and have conversations with you. And I'm sure through those conversations, you would have been able to peep into their soul and realize that even they are vulnerable, okay? I think the day we develop that consciousness, ki all of us are doing our best and the only thing we can give to each other is that love and compassion, that's the day you'll experience that satyug that we talk about. Okay. Today we live in an environment, and again, you can't blame it on an individual or on society at large, but where people derive more joy from another person's misery than their own joy, than the joy they derive from their own victory.
Yeah.
And it's mass consciousness, right? So the only thing we can do is keep reminding people that everybody's doing their best. And the best you can do for everybody and for yourself is provide that love and compassion.
Yeah. That's there. What do you think, which is the biggest industry where you feel the opportunity is there? Someone who's watching this, what do you think, which industry is going to have next $1 billion startups or businesses, or maybe like true value creation will happen in this space, which has not been explored yet? What are those gray areas or the white spaces?
I definitely believe the consciousness industry is going to grow. The more technology grows, the more need for human connection and consciousness is going to grow.
So can you give some examples of the businesses people have built in this?
The coaching industry, the healing industry is going to grow through the roof.
Wellness.
Yeah, wellness is going to grow through the roof. Okay, people are not seeing it. Okay, building tech for connection will be a great thing to do instead of just...
I was having this conversation with... you want to complete? I was having this conversation with one of our clients and they're building something in the metaverse. Mm. Okay. And I said, I really want you guys to succeed.
Mm.
And he said, why? Mm. I said, the reason is because if you build something in metaverse, I'm going to build exact opposite of you and try to build something with the human connection, because I know that all of your clients are going to be miserable with their personal lives. Yeah. I'm going to go help them. Yeah, yeah. Because if you make a $1 billion business, I'm going to make a $2 billion business out of it.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. I think anything to do with wellness, human connection, human consciousness is an untapped space still.
Mm-hmm.
Is a very untapped space.
Okay.
Today, a person gets more joy when they get likes on their picture than they get joy by just having a conversation, let's just say, with their spouse or their parent or their... Right? Why has that happened? It's happened because technology has now given a new definition saying likes is good. Okay, joy is good. So it's killing consciousness. A part of me is not okay with what's happening, how human conditioning is being changed by tech players on how they should experience emotion. Like, say this example or analogy I gave you, that a person feels more happiness when they get 10 likes on their picture than they get the joy they experience with their family, right? Now, that's one part of me which is not happy. Okay. The other part of me is like, say today, as a business owner, if I have to generate leads, I have to depend on social media giants. And there is zero transparency in social media giants about how my money gets utilized. Right?
Yeah.
I've done enough testing on social media to know that if I put a budget of 50,000 rupees for a 5-day ad, okay, versus I put a budget for a 2 lakh for a 3-day ad, my entire money will get used.
Yeah.
And probably the 50,000 will give me a better result
than
the 2 lakhs. So there's no transparency there.
Mm.
There is no, there's again too much decentralization, too much centralization of power.
Yeah.
Okay. If there's a social activist within me, I'd fight power. Okay. Because I think that's where humanity hits a downward spiral. Okay. So for us, what we wanted to do was this. One, we wanted to build tech that enables connection, human connection.
Okay.
Second, we wanted to solve the business problem of lead generation for businesses that are either left at the mercy of social media, where they don't have control on costs and there's no transparency, or they have to be a part of mundane networking organizations where you're forced to do activities in a networking organization, which are necessarily for the benefit of the networking organization, not directly beneficial to me.
Hmm.
Okay. So we've taken these two problems, broken our head for 6 to 8 months. And today we built a platform called Connext, which is for small and medium business owners, where a business owner, all they have to do is create their profile, their business profile, give us details of business profile. And then the technology will find them a person who has a requirement for their product or who has customers who require this person's product. To give you a simple example, if you are a recruiter and I am a trainer, you are building your recruitment business, you are constantly reaching out to HR managers. Yep. I'm a corporate trainer. I'm constantly talking to HR managers. Now, let's just say we find someone who's into corporate gifting, who's also talking to HR managers. Yeah. We talk to someone who is into payroll management, who's also talking to HR managers. Okay. Now, if we are able to put five or six such people together who are constantly selling to the same target customer, and we are able to connect them one-to-one, saying, match your value system, match your compatibility with each other, and then become partners who are referring clients to each other. Okay. Then you don't have to depend on technology or mundane networking.
Yeah.
Okay. And it's not like if you are a startup, I will connect you to a person who's 20 years in the industry, because then that will be an unfair relationship where only that 20-year-old, the person in 20 who's in business for 20 years will be able to help you, but you will not add value to him.
Yeah.
So what we are doing is we are curating connections of people who have the similar target customer, okay, but a non-competing product, but at the same life cycle of business. Okay. And the study shows that as a small and medium business, if I get 8 meetings in a month and I'm able to close 20% of my clients, that is good enough for me to not spend a rupee on marketing anywhere else. So what we are building this tech, we've already done a test phase with 400 entrepreneurs.
Okay.
Now the platform is live. It's not an app yet. It's a web link, connects.community, where we've onboarded another 500 entrepreneurs.
But isn't it very difficult to actually match all of this? It sounds very good in
theory. That's what we've been able to crack. That's the logic behind the algorithm is what we've been able to crack.
That's going
to
be your moat.
Yes, because at the end of the day, we've been in this space having a clientele of 190 different industries and sectors of SMEs. So we understand it. Most people who can build a tech still don't know the pulse of the variety of businesses and the complications. Yeah. We've been in that space for 15 years now. So that's what we are bringing to the table.
That's going to be. Yeah. But this is tech for good. Yeah. Okay. But do you think this will also turn into tech for consolidation? Everybody, this starts with empowerment.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Tech for good.
Yeah.
Let's say I am here. Taxi drivers are not getting enough business. So I'm going to get them and pool them together, provide them and become Uber. Right. Then I'm a seller. I'm not able to sell it. I'm going to give them a platform so that across India, people can buy it. So become Amazon. Mm. So they all start for tech for good in order to empower people
individuals.
But now, because they're so big, there are so many taxi drivers dependent on one thing. Yeah. They've consolidated the power together that Uber controls it.
Yep.
It's tech consolidation.
Yep.
So the power, it's again become a capitalism. Yep. Same with Amazon, right? Yep. So same if you do it with a lot of small entrepreneurs and everybody, don't you think you will also become like a consolidated tech?
And this is a thought that we've thought through. Because at the end of the day, like you said, everybody starts with empowerment. But then in the empowerment, EM goes out. And it becomes power.
Yeah.
Right? So that's the test we are going to put ourselves through. And that's the test we want the world to hold us responsible for. Today I've come here. I've had the conversation that I've had. This is going to stay online forever.
Yeah.
Right? So the reason I've had that conversation is because I'm willing to be held by the collar to say, Rajiv, are you sticking to what you said? We want to decentralize and democratize in a financially viable manner, a solution. That's the bold test / challenge / game we are playing at this point of time.
This takes balls to actually do that. Yeah. You need, I mean, I know for a fact that most of the people who come here, they would probably have 5 PR guarding them before this could go public. This is a bold statement that you want people to come up to you and hold you with a collar that, you said something else and now you're doing something else.
Yeah.
Thanks a lot. Thanks for doing this. I really enjoyed the conversation. I hope you did as well.
I loved it.